Hi and welcome to this new Quick Tech episode. My name is Philippe Ozil. I'm a developer advocate at Salesforce. And today I'm going to walk you through how you can create a flow screen component. As a side note, I also recorded a similar video that explains how you can create custom flow actions with Apex. Flow screen components are a building block that help you create engaging user experiences with flows. For example, you can use a flow screen component such as a text field or a date field to create a form. Flow screen components are implemented with Aura and Lightning Mode components. Let's switch over to VS Code and create a custom flow screen component. I'm going to write a simple Hello World component which takes a name parameter in and that displays a custom greeting message. I'll start by creating a new Lightning Mode component. I'm editing the JavaScript file here to expose a first name public property with an @API decorator. I'll now switch to the components template and I'll add a dynamic message that includes the first name property. Finally, the most important thing I need to do is to edit the component's metadata to specify that this component is a flow screen component. To do that, I need to add a lightning flow screen target. Now that I've set my target, I need to configure it to expose my name property in Flow Builder. Here, I could also add a configuration editor attribute if I wanted to set a custom property editor. I won't demonstrate custom property editors here, but in short, this lets you select a lightning mode component that replaces the default configuration form for your flow screen components in Flow Builder. This is a bit meta because we're talking about having a component that lets you configure a component. But the idea behind this is to provide a custom admin-friendly experience for your flow screen components. Back to my demo component. Here I'm adding the first name property with its name, label, type, and I'm marking it as required. Note that the value of the name attribute must match the Lightning Mode component public property defined from our JavaScript file. Since I'm editing my component's metadata, I'll also add a user-friendly label. At this point, I'm done with my components code, I can push it to my org. Now that my flow screen component is deployed, I'll go back to Flow Builder and I can show you how you can use it. I've prepared a sample screen flow with a screen in which I'll add my component. You can see my component there under Custom. I'll drag and drop it on the screen. Here's my component configuration. I can set my first name property with whatever I want, a hard-coded value, a flow variable, or even a constant. In my case, I'm going to use a global variable that holds the current user's first name. Let's now save the flow and run it to see our component. Here we see our greeting message with the dynamic template. That's it. That's how you build and use a custom flow screen component. This example was very simple, but it demonstrates the basics. If you'd like to get started fast with flows, check out automation components. Automation components are a set of reusable and production-ready extensions that include invocable actions, flow screen components, and local actions. These are intended as an easy to install, easy to use toolbox. And for even more community contributed flow resources, visit unofficialsf.com. That's it. Thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video and learned new things. If yes, like this video. Also, check out the other video regarding flow actions. And after that, if you want more content like this pushed directly to you, you can hit subscribe and that bell to get notifications as we get new content out. Thanks.